Hello, it's Vidas Pinkevičius, and in this video I will create a chorale prelude for organ Omnes qui in Christo, and this is taken from the Communion for the Baptism of Christ, Latin Gregorian chant setting, and I plan to do this on two manuals. The soprano part will be played on the swell with the solo registration. The bass part will have the pedal part will have basically counterpoint melody, and the two middle parts, alto and the tenor, will have movement in mostly in quarter notes, harmonic movement. Accompaniment. Okay, so let me first write in the melody for us. Let's decide on the meter first. Let's pick 3/4 meter for now. And it starts from the note D, like that. And we'll try to be a little more creative with the melody and with the harmony and with the tonal plan, and try to create interesting key changes. Sort of the first phrase indicates the mood of D. It starts like that. Maybe we'll add some rhythm, although the Gregorian chant melody is not too rhythmically complex. Like that. So, how about thinking in the mode of D, but without the key signal, without any key signatures? Yeah, it's sort of like a Dorian, D Dorian mode. And we'll now try to create a nice counter melody, which will repeat itself rhythmically, at least from various pitch levels. So in order to create a nice rhythmic movement, counter melody. Okay. Maybe let's start from the rest. And I'm just notating the rhythm now. Like that. Maybe we'll change a little bit as we go, but for now it will have a nice syncopation here and 16 note motion too. Okay. Like that. Maybe we can create and the second measure is this. Like this. Like that, okay? So our goal is to create a rhythmically interesting soprano part, and then we can obviously create a counter melody based on that rhythm. All right, like it here too. Okay, and here let's change that. Maybe we'll add a few more measures. Okay, that's our outline basically. 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, it's like ostinato, melodically interesting movement. And here too, and here. Okay, I don't know exactly how many measures we'll have, but let's now create the soprano part. Okay, we have the entrance, the first two measures, and then let's switch to the key of, to the key signature of F Dorian, which means we'll have 3 flats from here. Okay. We'll keep the Gregorian chant melody as it is, but we'll add 3 flats. And it'll start like this. It'll be good. Now next key signature will be from F Dorian. We'll have G sharp Dorian. Okay, that will mean five or six sharps from here. A little too early, right here. Like that. But for now, let's create something with the rhythm. With this rhythm, okay. How about moving from F? Like that. Like that. And next is let's create one more measure of a counterpoint here. Let's start. Alright. So we have this fragment, 2 phrases. 3 more to go. Because the Gregorian chant melody consists of 5 phrases. We have written the words omnes and then qui in Christo with 3 flats, and now with six sharps will be baptizati estis, and it will start with with this Alright. Quarter notes. Maybe dotted quarter note. Maybe without a dot here. Like that. Okay, I think we have created baptizati estis phrase. It's a little longer. And now let's create Christum Induistis. Christum Induistis will be in B Dorian, which will have three sharps. Okay. And we need to figure out the counterpoint. Maybe we'll use downward motion. Like that. Good. Here I'm aiming for the nice melodic motion in the bass with the climax with sort of a nice melodic arc, which will be just perfect for the soprano too, because we'll create the harmony in seventh chords, in various inversions of seventh chords, and inversions will be dictated by the counterpoint melody together with the soprano. Soprano and the bass will not change. The alto and the tenor will be harmonic notes. Okay. One more, like that. Like that. Okay. Maybe this way. So let's listen to what we have created so far. And the meter and the tempo. Let's create the tempo first in order to metronome mark. Quarter note is how about 60? And that means probably moderato. Here we'll create a tempo indication right here. Moderato. Good. So, quarter note means equals 60. I'm not sure what's happening. Let's redo it. The metronome indication. Quarter note equals 60. Like that. Okay. Like that. Let's listen. Like that. It's just the skeleton, of course, without the harmony. Now let's create the movement Christum Induistis. And it starts with the D note. So how about that at quarter note? Thank you. like that, and then a few more nodes. Okay, like that. And let's create the counterpoint now. Like that. Like that. Good. And one more. The last phrase is, of course, in D without any accidentals. Here we go. Alleluia. The word is Alleluia. So let's create the soprano melody. That. Maybe let's leave it to the quarter note here. Let's calculate how many Fs we have. 1, 2, 3, 4. No, too many. Let's do this. Like that. Let's, I think, end this prelude with this last long note. Obviously, this will be on D. Create create the counterpoint. Like that. Let's listen to the two voices one more time before we create anything else. Okay, I would only change this note in order for the counterpoint not to have too many repeated notes. And here, I think, like that, a little bit smoother. So now let's create these tenor and alto parts. I think what we have to do is to create a four-part harmony with smooth melodic lines, always thinking about the seventh chords and their inversions. For example, it will start we can create obviously the meter, the rhythm right away because the melody will change but the meter will stay in quarter notes. And the second voice will start also. Like that. Very fast, very easy. Just like the counterpoint, we will change the melodic counter based on the chord. But now we'll have something to work with. So the first chord has the soprano D and the bass D. Obviously, this is a seventh chord, incomplete seventh chord. We need the C in the soprano in the tenor. And F in the tenor F and C in the alto, like that. Or maybe we could have higher. Yeah, let's do alto F and tenor C. Okay, when we have the F in the bass, we can have either 6-5 chord or 4-3 chord or even 4-2 chord. Alright. Maybe. Maybe like that. F, B, G, and D. 4-2 chord. And then obviously this will be F and D, F and C. F and C might have a 7th chord. Like that. Like that. Good. We'll finish the second measure now. C in the bass indicates the 4-2 chord. F and A are missing. Okay, repeated note, we can tie it over. Good. E and D in the next beat, 7th chord. We could have missing notes G and B. Like that. And one more. D and D. Obviously, this is a 7th chord. F and C are missing. Okay, like that. Let's listen to the two measures. Like that. Oh. That will be smooth enough. Good. Now the next note in the bass is F, and in the soprano is C. We could have either 7th chord or the 6-5 chord. How about 6-5 chord? F, A flat, C, and a D, starting from the bass. So D and A flat. Good. C and C, 7th chord, missing notes are E flat and B flat. Good. Next, D and C. D and C means we have 4-2 chord. C, D, F, A flat. So F, A flat, good. Now we'll have B flat in the bass and F. which would have obviously 6-5 chord or 7th chord. Okay. How about 7th chord? B flat, D, F, A flat. Like that, maybe let's change the tenor. B flat, D, we need D, D, F, and A flat, like that. Good, and now the next beat, F and D. This could be 6-5 chord, 4-2 chord, or even 4-3 chord, any chord. Well, let's do 4-3 chord. F, A flat, B flat, D. F, A flat, B flat, D. F, A flat, B flat, D. Or, depending on the, yeah, let's do this. In tonal harmony in voice leading, the widest distance between the three upper parts allowed is no more than an octave. So between the alto and the tenor, the alto and the soprano cannot be more than an octave. But we are not in tonal harmony, we are creating really free composition, so I think we'll be okay. The only thing we should not do is voice crossings, which complicate things a little bit. Yes, from time to time it's possible to do them, but I don't think we will have a need for that. Good. So the last version is this last beat, the note E and D. That's obviously the 7th chord. E flat, G, B flat, and D. So we need to have B flat and G. Good, and one more beat, one more measure. Now we can have E flat and D again. I think we could have a little different bass note for this matter, because we would not want to repeat the harmony across the bar line. So now we have D and D, that's obviously the 7th chord, incomplete 7th chord. F and D notes are missing. Like that. Like that. Then let's do, let's go back a little bit. I think we need to redo this to put A flat here and D here. Yeah, a little bit smoother. Yeah, voice leading is important. And here too. We flip tenor and alto like that. Now we'll have everything in order, no more than an octave between the three upper parts. Good. The next is G and D. This can be 7th chord, 6-5 chord, any of those chords. Let's do 6-5 chord. We have G, we need B flat and E flat. Like that, and one more. G and D again. Let's switch to the seventh chord. G sharp or G, B flat, D and F. Like that, we do this, and one more is in the next already mode, C sharp and D. Obviously, this will be a 4-2 chord. C sharp, D sharp, F sharp, and A sharp. Like that. Let's listen to the first line. Like that, good. Now let's think about the next chord. The next chord will be A sharp and D. A sharp and D. This is the sign of the either 4-2 chord or 4-3 chord. Let's do 4-3 chord. Or 4-2, yeah, 4-2. A sharp, B, D sharp, and F. Like that. We change. Good. And G sharp. G sharp and F. That's obviously the seventh chord. We need to have B and D sharp. Maybe we'll change will change the switch places. Like that. Obviously, we need probably the treble clef here. Yeah, much better. Not too low. Because the soprano is kind of high, therefore we need most of the time the open chord position. Everything is okay. Good, now next is this. The first note in the bass is B, and then F sharp in the soprano. Means the seventh chord or the 6-5 chord. Let's do 6-5 chord. D sharp and G sharp are missing. Good. Next is G sharp and D sharp. Let's do seventh chord. F sharp and B are missing. Good. And the last beat in this measure is D sharp and G sharp. So let's do 6-5 chord. G sharp B, D sharp E sharp. Good. Now let's do the interesting chord on the first beat of the next measure, 4-2 chord, because we have the B in the bass and C sharp in the soprano, 4-2. B, C sharp, E sharp, and G sharp needed. So E sharp and yeah, like that. Next is E sharp and E sharp. We need seventh chord, incomplete seventh chord. G sharp and D sharp is missing. Like that, we need this. Okay, and we need this next chord, D sharp and G sharp. We need either 4-3 chord or 4-2 chord. Okay, two versions. So let's do 4-2 chord. D sharp, E sharp, G sharp, and B sharp. Okay. Like that. Next is A sharp in the bass and G sharp. That's a seventh chord. A sharp, C sharp, E sharp, and G sharp. We have A sharp and G sharp. Missing are C sharp and E sharp. Okay. See how smooth the movement is. And because we have tied over note, syncopation in the soprano, even in the tenor too, but the alto is moving, and that is okay. At least one voice is giving us the beat, the stronger beat. Next. Next, the second measure is, the second beat of the measure is C sharp in the bass and E sharp in the soprano. That could be the 7th chord, 3-4 chord, everything except 4-2 chord, basically. Let's do 4-3 chord. C sharp, E sharp, F sharp and A sharp. Good. Next, same thing. Tied over note, dotted note in the soprano. We could have simply the 7th chord. G sharp, E sharp, G sharp, C sharp, E sharp, G sharp and B. Like that. And now next measure starts with B in the bass and soprano. Which means we have either 6-5 chord, either 4-2 chord or 4-3 chord too. Let's do the 6-5 chord. B sharp, D sharp, F sharp and G sharp. F sharp and D sharp are missing. Like that. Good. And we need next chord, GG. G sharp in the bass, soprano is also G sharp. That's incomplete 7th chord. Like that. Maybe we'll do this tenor voice, the up note here, and we'll need the third beat, F sharp and G sharp. We need probably the 4-2 chord. B and G sharp are missing. Like that. If this is the case, maybe we can have the dotted note. How about the next chord we'll have? E sharp and G sharp, that's a 7th chord. Like that. Wide position, open position. G sharp and G sharp, that's the 7th chord. Missing notes are B and F sharp. And here next is G sharp again. But remember, sometimes, like in this instance, when we have a fixed note in the soprano, we cannot really change that, and we cannot change the base, right? Because it's tied over. Maybe we can leave the G sharp as the non-chordal note, but the A sharp will be the chordal note. Okay. Suspension. And that will be our seventh chord, the sign of the seventh chord. A sharp, C sharp, E sharp, and G sharp. Good, like that. And one more. Next will be this. F sharp and C sharp. That could be either 7th chord or the 6-5 chord. Let's create 6-5 chord. So we have F sharp, A sharp, C sharp, and D sharp. And D sharp in the alto. Seventh chord here. And here C sharp and C sharp. That's the seventh chord. Incomplete seventh chord. Good. Let's listen to the beginning one more time. Like that. Okay, maybe I'll change this note to G sharp. It will be a chordal note, and we'll have this tied over note here. Good. I think half of that of our piece is done. And next is with three sharps, G sharp and D. We need either 7th chord or the 6-5 chord. Okay, next let's do the 6-5 chord. G sharp, B, D, and E. Like that. Like that, good. Next is B in the bass and D in the soprano. Which could be either 7th chord, 6-5 chord, or the 4-2 chord. 4-3 chord, sorry. Could be B, D, E, and G sharp. but it's the same harmony as the previous beat. So maybe we'll keep the 6-5 chord then. F sharp here. Good, and the next is B and D sharp. B and D, that's again either 7th chord or the 6-5 chord or 4-2 chord. Let's do 4-2 chord. Or maybe 7th chord. Let's do 7th chord. B, D, F sharp, and A. This way. A and F sharp is next. Which means we could have either 6-5 chord, 4-2 chord, or the 4-3 chord. Let's do 4-2 chord. A, B, D, F sharp. A, B, D, F sharp. Good, and next is C sharp in the bass and F sharp in the soprano. Either 4-2 chord or 4-3 chord or, yeah, these two versions. 3-4 chord maybe. C sharp. E, A, and F sharp. And then next is D and F sharp. Let's do 7th chord. D, F sharp, A, and C sharp. D, F sharp, A, and C sharp, like that. Wide open position. One more measure. D, F sharp. Let's do now 6-5 chord. D, F sharp, A, B. Like that. Next is F sharp and F sharp. That's the 7th chord. A and E. And here is D. 6-5 chord. Let's do 6-5. F sharp, A, C sharp, D. F sharp, A, C sharp, and D. This way. Okay, so stationary alto line. Next would be C sharp and F sharp. That could be our 4-3 chord. C sharp, E, F sharp and A. Good. One more. E and F sharp. That's the 4-2 chord. E, F sharp, A and C sharp. Okay, and seventh chord, F sharp and F sharp. Like that. Maybe this time I will strike the alto one more time, this A. Okay, lots of alto sustaining notes. F sharp and F sharp again. Let's do the E here. Or maybe C sharp. C sharp and F sharp. Let's do the 4-2 chord. C sharp, D sharp, F sharp and A. Like that. Next is A and F sharp. 3-4. Let's do 3-4 chord. A, C sharp, D, F sharp. And here A and D. A in the bass, D in the soprano. Maybe we could do 4-2 chord. A, B, D, F sharp. Okay, that's better. That. And the next measure starts D sharp, G sharp and D. Let's do 6-5 chord. G sharp, B, D and E. Like that. Let's do this and this. One more measure of this chord. Seventh chord, C sharp and C sharp. Good. And this 4-2 chord. B in the bass, C sharp in the soprano. Like that. Let's do this. And this. And let's start the last one, seventh chord. G natural and F natural. B and D are missing. Like that. Good. Let's go back to the beginning and listen to it again. Okay, and maybe the last phrase starts from the seventh chord, and the second beat starts. Let's do the seventh chord again. And here. The tenor is stationary. A and F is next. That would be this 6-5 chord. Like that. The next chord is also A, but let's do the 4-3 chord, or even 4-2 chord, maybe 4-3 chord. A, C, D, F. Okay, and F, F. A and E are missing, that's the seventh chord. Good, next measure, couple of measures left. A and F. That's the sign of the 4-2 chord. Let's do 4-2. A, B, D, and F. Next is C and F. Let's do this four-three chord. C, E, A, and F. And next is again F. So that would be. How about the 4-2 chord? C, D, A, and F. And starting the note. The next measure, penultimate measure from A and D. That's the sign of the 4-3 or 4-2 chord. Let's do 4-3 chord. A, C, D and F. Wait, the previous chord was like that, only different inversion. Maybe let's change one note. C to B. Then we'll have the 4-2 chord. A, F, B, D. Good. Let's now we'll have 4-3 chord. F, D. F, D. Let's do the 4-2 chord. F, G. F, G, B, and D. And the 7th chord. D and D. F and C are missing here. Okay. Let's do the fermata here sign. Okay. And here too. Let's listen to the whole piece. Okay, we can write in ritenuto at the end, slowing down right towards the end. What else do we need? I think we need a few things. We need the registration. Let's write in the text. Suggested registration right here. Swell. Grid. And pedals. Okay, obviously pedals will have soft or flutes. Let's do flutes. 16 and 8. Grid will have flutes of 8 and 4. And as well, we'll have the flutes 8, 4, and 3. Maybe we'll write conventional way. That is the fifth. 2 2/3. Recommended suggested registration. Suggested registration. Okay. Obviously, the soprano will play with this well. Good. Now the alto and the tenor will have the grid. And the pedals obviously will have pedal sign. But we don't need that because we have this here. Good. What else? Expression, right? Let's write in the expression. Dynamics, right? How about mezzo forte? In this well. And the grid will have mezzo piano, as well as these two, the pedals, mezzo piano, not too loud. Good, let's write in one more thing. Technique, or maybe it will be like again let's write legato everywhere. So we have dynamics, we have the articulation, we have the registration. The only thing that we need is this. What about creating a little bit smoother line in the alto and the tenor, if we can, by adding passing notes? Whenever we see the interval of the third, we can do the passing tone. Okay? Like here. Like that. Or here. Yes. Smoother voice leading. And here. And here. That will be like a nice choral prelude, I think. Not too complicated things. Obviously, we need to have the melody in the soprano present at all times. Therefore, just a few passing notes. like that. And here too. And here too. And here too. And here. And here too. That's it. We could also create very easily the neighbor tones by taking the repeated note red and moving it stepwise. For example, if between two repeated notes B and B we have the note either A or C, B C B or B A B. But I think it will be quite enough. One last time, let's listen to it. Okay, I think this could be it. This could work, I think. This could work. One thing, I think, is clear. So, I think if you like the score and would like to play it, visit my website at www.organduo.lt, organduo.lt, Secrets of Organ Playing, and there you find my compositions, and also you can print them out, and also there will be a link at the information field of this video. And if you would like to create something like that yourself, go ahead and try. You can see that it's a very simple process, right? All we did is to notate the melody, then create a counterpoint in the bass. And the melody was sort of not static, not equal notes, but melodically and rhythmically interesting, very varied. And all we did with the middle parts, alto and tenor, was to fill in the blanks, fill in the missing notes of the seventh chords and their inversions. And of course, I needed more harmonic interest for that, and we added various key signatures. We started with zero accidentals, then three flats, six sharps, three sharps, and basically zero again. So you can do that too. And the last step was obviously to create passing notes in the middle parts to avoid monotony. Okay. So thank you for watching, and enjoy your practice, enjoy your creative endeavors and adventures. Go ahead and try your piece, create, take a melody of any kind. You can do folk tune, hymn tune, chorale tune, Gregorian chant tune, even the anthem of your country would work. Any kind of melody. Or you can compose the melody yourself. So, thanks for watching, and I'll see you again next time.